What's up, Titos and Titas? Jerry and Kwan here. You're watching TitoFit, and in this channel, we talk about health, we talk about fitness, we talk about wellness and living your best life as a Tito or a Tita. We are gonna talk about something that's a commonly held belief of a lot of people who go to the gym and like to, you know, improve their physique through supplementation and even diet. My name is Jordan Conde and I am a 16-year veteran of the fitness industry. I have coached in 3 different countries in the world and I like to share some of my tips and some of my experiences to help out clients and you guys, whoever are watching this, for your fitness to help you achieve your goals. Now, please don't take this, whatever I say in this video, as medical advice. Always check with a qualified professional, nutritionist, sports nutritionist ideally. Okay? So, before we begin, please don't forget to subscribe and give this video a like. Right? So, that will help out this channel tremendously. So, today we're gonna talk about the anabolic window. Okay? So, there is this wide-held belief that there is a time or a period of time around your workout, what we also known as the peri-workout window, the peri-workout period, that's about 3 to 5 hours around your workout, that you should take in protein and some fast digesting carbs immediately after you work out, up to about the hour immediately after your workout, to maximize muscle gains. And that basically this is actually more important than your protein intake all throughout the day. A lot of people actually go as far as to say that, you know, if you don't do this, you're actually wasting time in the gym. Now, don't get me wrong, I was one such person who used to believe this. Now, of course, like I always say, the science is alive, the science is changing, we get more updates as research and as studies are done. And the area of physique enhancement is actually ahead of the curve in a lot of respects when it comes to this, because bodybuilders are, you and strength athletes are usually pushing the envelope as far as experimenting with their bodies, and to a certain degree, a lot of scientists are now catching up, being able to catch up. We have a lot of scientists who are in the fields of the nutritional sciences, of sports nutrition, who are actually practicing bodybuilders or strength athletes themselves. Now, here's the thing. This belief that you had to have a lot of protein in the period right after your workout became so extreme that some people would actually like spend so much money on proteins that had a much more rapid uptake than the others. So then came, at first it was whey concentrate, that moved on to whey isolate, and then eventually that moved on, they weren't happy with that, and they moved on to whey hydrolysate, which are fractionated proteins and are absorbed much faster. They would take this hydrolysate to take advantage of these protein window, this anabolic window, wherein it was actually suggested that your body could digest protein and help MPS or muscle protein synthesis as much as 200% more than other times of the day. And then this would actually be enhanced by the intake of fast digesting carbohydrates such as sugar or dextrose even. I knew some people who would take dextrose, or some people would take Vitargo, a high molecular weight carbohydrate that was absorbed very, very rapidly to replenish your glycogen stores in the muscle. So that was the long-held belief. But in more recent years, a lot of the research has tried to catch up. And actually, in fact, it did. So a lot of studies will now compare people who would take most of their protein around that peri-workout window or that anabolic window as compared to people who would take their protein spread out throughout the day. And what they found out was that in the long run, what matters is that you actually hit your protein goals for the day as compared to just getting it all after you work out. So the application here is that it does not actually matter as much as you think. Now this, yes, there, does that mean that you no longer take a protein shake after workout? No. You can still take advantage of that, of the muscle protein synthesis increase in your body by still taking a protein shake, but do you have to be so anal about it and spend so much money on things like whey hydrolysates? Maybe not. Do you still have to buy Vitargo? Maybe not. You can probably just have normal whey protein concentrate or isolate if you are lactose intolerant, and it'll probably work the same way. Do you have to take like 100 grams of protein after your workout? No, probably not. The more important thing is to hit your protein requirements for the day. And actually, they found out that to maximize this muscle protein synthesis, that the simple way to do it is to spread your intake over 3 feedings. It can be done in 2 if you are practicing intermittent fasting or time-restricted feeding, but ideally 3. So 3 feedings, the way to do it is to multiply your weight in kilos by times 0.4 or times 0.55 on the higher end. And this will be your ideal protein intake per feeding. Okay? And hopefully, that gets you to your daily protein requirement for wanting to maximize your lean body mass or grow muscles, which is 1.6 grams per kilogram of body weight. Now that is the ideal intake. Now, if you're really lazy, you can just multiply your body weight in pounds by 1. So if you weigh 150 pounds, try to get as close as possible to 150 grams of protein per day. Now if you really want to be exact about it, it's gonna be your weight in kilograms times 1.6, okay? And multiply it, spread out evenly across about 3 feedings of 0.4 to 0.55 per kilogram of your weight. Now we are gonna post these numbers here, so make sure you check it out in the video, and hopefully you guys appreciated this video. Let me know in the comments if you were actually one of the people who believed in this anabolic window, or is this the first time you're hearing about it. And I hope you guys stay strong and stay safe during the season. Keep working out at home. What else are you gonna do anyway? So see you in the next one.